To be successful in designing your brand for enduring value, you need clarity and focus. Concentration is a critical element in the pursuit to deliver a strong brand. My name is Catherine Gaho, and I've spent many years as a trainer, researcher, and entrepreneur in the field of marketing. One of the questions I've been asked many times is, how do you create a compelling brand for your business? Brand management is viewed as one of the most significant capabilities in marketing. Building a brand is a fundamental aspect in the product or service marketing strategy. A brand may be characterized as a name, logo, or trademark that is used to identify and differentiate the products and services of a particular company. Distinctiveness is of great importance in branding, as it helps a brand to stand out in the marketplace, allowing it to hold sway in the minds of consumers. Some brand-oriented companies actually choose to focus purely on brand building. They subcontract everything else. They subcontract manufacturing, warehousing, distribution, and so on. They focus on quality assurance and on working the brand strategy. They handle all product distribution, pricing, and policy decisions, but they let others do the implementation. It's their duty to ensure that the product meets the highest standard of production. They have to ensure that the product is consistent and that it meets customer expectations. The main objective of brand building is to inspire a positive image in the customer's mind in order to develop a deep relationship and to enhance long-term profitability. The customer does not need to know who makes the brand in situations like this, where the brand owner has decided to subcontract manufacturing. They just need to know the brand and its owner, the company that takes all responsibility for all the brand's outcomes. The company that is the mother of the brand, so to say. Think about it. When you go to buy a phone, do you ask who made the body or the specific components of the phone? I definitely don't. And when you buy apples, what is different about that? When you go to buy apples, you might want to know from what farm they are coming from. Where were they grown? Why do you want to know that? Because apples generally are a commodity, not a brand. And that's the power of a brand. Many farms that grow apples are now branding their apples by putting the farm name, because people are then able to know that apples from this farm are sweet, or apples from this farm are crunchy, and then you decide what is it that you are going to buy. I still remember some other advertisements about chicken from Purdue Farm. They used to say, chicken is not a chicken, it's not a chicken. And then they proceed to list all the unique identifiers of a Purdue chicken. They were trying to demonstrate the difference, the value, the uniqueness, and the quality that chicken from their farm delivered. One of the most important things in brand building is to recognize that the ultimate aim of a brand is to create enduring relationship with customers. Customers relate with a brand as they would people, as they would friends. How they relate with their friends or neighbors or family or even frenemies. Brand image is the perception of the brand held in consumers' mind. It relates to the mental associations, perceptions, and attitudes that consumers hold about the brand. Brand image encompasses the memories, the myths, emotions, and feelings associated with the brand. When consumers use the brand, they remember, what were the emotions? Where was I? That's why you find, in some cases, people look at their history and remember brands that grew with them, brands that were there in their childhood. And that's why sometimes people even go back and start to look at old advertisements as a way of seeing what a brand used to say to their parents in the old days, so that they could select to stick and be loyal to that brand and actually keep telling their children about it until they grew older and they did not know any other way. Have you noticed that some of the brands, like in Kenya, tea, there are no two homes where tea is made exactly the same. And there was this connection that people had from when they were young. They grew up enjoying some of these brands as a family. So the emotions that it carries. Think of some of the soft drinks. Today, of course, we are being told, oh, you know, they have sugar and the like. But the memory people hold of those brands are about the relationships they had in their families, the events they attended, where they partook of these brands. And that's why they continue to value those brands. Before I close, I have a question for you. What action will you take in the next few days to clarify your brand value? Start by taking one action only and you'll build momentum to reach where you want to go. All the best. Thank you for watching this video. If you think this material is useful, press the subscriber button on your screen right now and also like it so that we can bring you more of the same.